Ancient people only knew as much about our sun as they could see with the naked eye. Today, we have telescopes and other technology that help us make better observations. But what if we could investigate our sun up close? Recently, scientists have designed and launched a probe on its first in human history journey to the sun. So how close did a spacecraft get? What did it find? And why didn't it melt? Get ready to discover this and some other mysteries of our neighboring star. Without the sun, no life on Earth would be possible. But this gigantic ball of hot plasma can also threaten us. Its bursts of radiation, also known as solar flares, and its explosive ejections of plasma called coronal mass ejections, accompanied by intense magnetic fields, can be frightening. Even though the sun's activity causes spectacular auroras on Earth, spacecraft, satellites, high-flying airplanes, and even astronauts can be in danger. Because of solar storms, our telecommunications, navigation systems, and power grids can fail to properly operate. We haven't been able to understand the sun and how it works, or when it's going to throw a massive ball of fiery plasma our way. This is why scientists have long dreamed of studying our star from a close distance. We know that the solar wind is a constant stream of charged particles that gains enough speed to escape the sun's outermost layer, the corona. But we don't know how energy and heat move through the corona and what accelerates solar energetic particles. Astronomers have been seeking the answers to these questions for 50 years, but to no avail. Finding answers meant sending a spacecraft through the corona that reaches about 1.1 million degrees Celsius, and it seemed impossible to accomplish until recently. This is what the Parker Solar Probe was made for, and it's truly a marvel of human technology. In 2018, NASA has successfully launched the Parker Solar Probe to revolutionize our understanding of the sun and space weather. The Parker Solar Probe was designed to become the first spacecraft to enter the sun's atmosphere. It's the size of a small car, and it weighs 685 kilograms. The spacecraft has several important instruments on board. The Solar Wind Electrons, Alphas and Protons Investigation, or SWEEP, will sample particles in the solar wind. The instrument has four sensors that calculate the abundance of particles. The Wide Field Imager for Solar Probe Plus, or WISPER, is a telescope that can take 3D images of our star's corona and any structures that pass by the probe. Another tool that Parker is equipped with is called Integrated Science Investigation of the Sun. It's made of two separate instruments, each having a different energy range. The instrument can weigh highly energetic heavy ions, electrons, and protons moving through the sun's atmosphere. Lastly, made of magnetometers and electric field antennas, the Parker Solar Probe will use electromagnetic fields investigation tool to analyze magnetic fields, radio emissions, and density of the sun's corona. But how can the Parker Solar Probe get so close to our star without melting? To study the sun under such extreme conditions, the probe and its instruments are equipped with a super reflective coating and a shield that measures 2.3 meters in diameter facing the sun. The shield, called the Thermal Protection System, is made of 11.5 centimeters of thick carbon composite. This makes the Parker Solar Probe capable of withstanding temperatures outside the spacecraft that reach roughly 1,370 degrees Celsius. And even though that might not seem like enough protection, the density of the sun's corona isn't high, and not many particles actually hit the probe. The spacecraft and its instruments are also strategically placed in the center of the shadow that's coming from the shield. The Parker Solar Probe also has sensors to let it know that the heat shield has been adjusted when needed. Another level of protection is located on the inside of the probe. Parker has a dual array of solar panels and a smart cooling system. The cooling system circulates water behind the solar cells where it gets heated. Then this same water is pushed down into the radiators where it's cooled. All this makes the Parker probe resistant to heat and radiation like no other space probe before it. And even with that level of protection and low density of the corona, Parker can only stay in this layer of the sun for a few hours. But how in the world is it possible to even send a probe towards the sun? It's 150 million kilometers away and would take forever to get there. reaching the sun isn't that simple. When a spacecraft is launched into space, whatever velocity rockets give it will be superimposed on top of Earth's orbital velocity, meaning that we can either cause the spacecraft to have more or less orbital energy than the Earth does. We can either boost it to a higher, less tightly bound orbit with respect to the sun, or de-boost it to a lower, more tightly bound orbit. Most of our space probe missions use planetary gravity to accelerate spacecraft and give them more orbital energy. But with Parker, scientists needed to do the opposite, make it lose orbital energy. The Parker Solar Probe has used multiple slingshot orbits using Earth, Mercury, and mostly Venus to enable it to get this close to the Sun. And each time it goes around the Sun, the probe picks up an insane amount of speed. Astronomers call it gravity assist, and it helps Parker narrow its orbit around the Sun and bring its perihelion about 6.4 kilometers closer. So, did it actually touch the Sun? Unlike Earth and some other planets, the Sun doesn't have a solid surface, but it still has a boundary. The point where the Sun's gravity and its magnetic forces keep in the solar material is called the Alvain critical surface. According to astronomers' calculations, it should be anywhere between 10 to 20 solar radii from the surface of the Sun, which is roughly 7 to 13.8 million kilometers. And scientists believe that it marks our star's boundary. With every gravitational maneuver, the spacecraft narrowed its distance to the Sun, and as it did so, astronomers searched for signs that the Parker Solar Probe had reached the critical surface. So what happened when NASA's spacecraft arrived at its destination? As the probe passed through a pseudo-streamer or a loop-like structure in the corona of the star, the whirlwind of particles started moving much slower, limiting the impact on the probe. This meant that the magnetic fields were dominant in that region so that no particles could escape it. It was the proof that the Parker was inside the Alvain critical surface. The spacecraft then recorded a video of coronal streamers moving past it. It was the first time scientists were able to see these mysterious objects from up close. The data collected from the probe shows that switchbacks or zigzag structures in the solar wind are quite abundant close to our star. Before, astronomers thought these zigzag structures were rather an abnormality occurring near the Sun's poles only. But the spacecraft helped scientists conclude that these structures originate in the solar surface and are quite common. Parker has also discovered that the critical surface was 18.8 solar radii from the solar surface, and it took 8 flybys and over 3 years to finally get there. But this wasn't the only discovery made by Parker that fascinated scientists. Multiple flybys near Venus have opened more opportunities to study this hot world. Until recently, astronomers didn't know exactly what the planet's surface looked like. Usually it's covered with thick clouds, so a big part of the visible light coming from the surface of Venus is shrouded from sight. Parker didn't only manage to record the atmosphere of our Sun, but it also captured Venus's surface from space. During its flybys, Parker used its wide-field camera to take images of the entire night side in wavelengths of the visible spectrum. For the first time, scientists were seeing Venus's surface in visible wavelengths from space. Even on the night side, the surface of the planet is roughly 475 degrees Celsius. It's so hot that you could see its rocky surface glowing. So far, the spacecraft has approached the Sun at a distance of 8.5 million kilometers from its surface. The previous record was set by the Helios 2 spacecraft in 1976, and the distance was only about 43.5 million kilometers. Aside from that, Parker is also breaking space speed records. During one of its approaches, it was moving at about 700,000 kilometers per hour. At that speed, it would take Parker about 1 second to get from Philadelphia to Washington, D.C., or less than a minute from New York to Tokyo. This makes it the fastest human object ever made. Scientists haven't found answers to all their questions yet, but as the spacecraft enters the Sun's atmosphere again and again, we'll find more clues. The Sun has an 11-year activity cycle during which its stormy behavior intensifies and then settles back down to a minimum. And because it currently ramps up, its corona will expand, giving the Parker probe even more opportunities to enter it again and stay in there for a bit longer. Eventually, the spacecraft will get as close as 6.1 million kilometers from the Sun's surface. This is just within the orbit of Mercury, which is roughly 7 times closer than any spacecraft has ever approached the Sun before. The Parker Solar Probe hasn't finished its mission yet. NASA wants to send the spacecraft deeper into the solar atmosphere to collect more data about how our neighboring star works. It'll help better understand the phenomena happening inside and around the Sun. The Sun is the only star we can study from such a close distance and the only one known to us that can support life. So, if we understand it well enough, we can succeed at searching for life outside our solar system. Eventually, the probe and its instruments will start failing, and the spacecraft will melt into a charred piece of metal that'll keep orbiting the big glowing ball of hot plasma. Its journey will come to an end, but until then, it could surprise us with more fascinating discoveries. So stay tuned, as we'll make sure to tell you everything about that.